Welcome everybody to Zappa's 10x10 Sessions, where we celebrate 10 years of growth in XR through a series of inspiring 10-minute subject matter expert interviews across the spectrum, from agencies to platforms, tool specialists, journalists, investors, business leaders, educators and more. And we hope these bite-sized anecdotes inspire and encourage more people into the world of XR. And today I'm joined by Jeremy Dalton, the XR lead from PwC. He's a prolific keynote speaker, author of many XR reports, and most recently, highly acclaimed book, Reality Check. So Jeremy, I think you're just about qualified to speak on this matter. And thank you very much for taking the time out of your diary to join us. For the benefit of the audience, Jeremy, could you explain your role at PwC and, interesting, how you got into the world of XR?
Absolutely. And I really appreciate you having me on this 10x10, Martin. So thanks a lot for that. I take care of the XR team in PwC UK, and we as a team are mainly involved in talking to businesses all around the world about how to implement XR technology. So if you looked at my day-by-day calendar, I think you'd see a lot of different things. You'd see some research into new and emerging platforms in XR. You'd see some dealing with clients in different industries, having chats to them about how they could potentially use the technology. A lot of conversations around how we get headsets set up and sent all over the world. You know, we're dealing with hundreds of these headsets right now, so logistically the exercise does become a little bit challenging. But I guess in summary, the role is quite varied, but that's what makes it so wonderful at the same time. In terms of how I got into XR in the first place, I actually have had a weird and wonderful trajectory into XR. I used to teach mathematics online. I was a software developer for 3 days. That's a story for another time. I was summarizing lecture notes for disabled students at a university. I was dealing with the stocking and the shelving in a department store. So all sorts of things. And eventually I made my way to PwC, as the company had a good reputation and it seemed like a solid career choice. While I was there, I meandered about from audit to business recovery and then to innovation before finally landing and building the XR team at PwC, because I saw such value in the technology to change our personal and professional lives.
Great. That is definitely a story with a couple more interviews in there to dive a bit deeper. But what you mentioned there, I think, is fascinating, because your role touches on so many different industries, use cases, and dare say it, different levels of understanding of tech and how to use it. So under your belt, you must have so many learnings across those years of how to basically scale this within different companies, let alone within PwC itself. What would you say would be your key learnings out of that time?
I'd say one of the key learnings would be that because virtual reality and augmented reality are such unique, visceral, experiential technologies, or another way of putting it, they're unique in the sense that they're front end as opposed to back end. So they're presenting you with information, they're putting you in different worlds and different environments. It's a very visual experience. And because of that, what I found is that when you are engaging with other people around the value of the technology, in order to get them to buy into it, they really need to experience it firsthand. And secondly, another important learning is that when speaking to business leaders, a lot of them tend to have this all or nothing approach. In other words, we are going to spend, you know, or consider spending millions and millions of dollars on implementing this technology, or we're not going to do anything at all. It's very difficult to find some middle ground there, but that's really where you need to be, especially for when you're first starting to introduce XR within an organization. It needs to be tested. Start with a pilot program, start small. Based on that, build a business case, get some data, and then present that case to show that if we extrapolated it and expanded it out into the wider business, then you'd be in a much stronger position.
And are you finding the world becoming more reliant on that data to prove the investment.
Absolutely. The big word in the industry or phrase return on investment gets talked about a lot, and it makes sense. Business leaders want to understand what they're going to get from implementing this technology. So you can show return on investment in many ways, but one of the strongest ways is going to the data and digging into it, analyzing it, and presenting it back to help build that case. So really, data-backed arguments are the precursor to building these business cases, which will help to implement them more successfully and get more buy-in from stakeholders and organizations.
Great, and we definitely see that in our world, and it's come up quite a bit in these interviews as well. So thanks for sharing those learnings. And I suppose as we look forward into the XR roadmap, is there anything out there on the horizon that you've spotted that you are really looking forward to and makes a difference to the XR space?
So I'm super excited about two key areas. The first is volumetric video. Now, for those of you listening who haven't heard of volumetric video before, let me explain some of the forms of content that you can bring into virtual reality and augmented reality experiences. You've got computer-generated content, which starts its life on a computer and ends there. So it's purely digital information, you know, a digital room, a digital table, a digital chair, and so on. Then there's 360 video. Now, 360 video is pretty much what it sounds like. You've got a camera in the middle of the room, but instead of just taking a small rectangular shot in front of you, it is taking a video or image of the entire environment, the 360 degrees around you. Then you've got volumetric video. Now, volumetric video is kind of the inverse of 360 video. Instead of having a camera in the middle of the room shooting outwards, you've got these cameras all around you shooting inwards, capturing you or someone else, you know, doing some sort of action, you know, speaking, running, jumping, dancing, whatever it is. And the amazing thing about this technology is it takes all of those videos from all those angles and produces a 3D model of you and then slaps on a texture effectively or the video of you onto the 3D model. So it's a great way of creating a three-dimensional model of someone that is photorealistic. And I think that's really exciting because imagine how it could be used for training purposes to bring real life individuals into an experience, for communication purposes to help convey a message to someone. And then the second thing I'm really excited about is WebXR. And WebXR is all about taking XR experiences, and instead of you having to install an application to access them, it simply becomes a case of going to your browser and entering a link to start the experience. Now, why is that so special or important, you might think? It's important because it reduces the friction of the experience for the end user. So imagine all the steps you've got to do to install an app, find an application, install it, run it, get it open, access the right functionality, and then get going. Now, all you have to do is scan a QR code or click on a link, and there it is, the XR experience is there. And that will help drive adoption of this technology in the industry.
Definitely, and we've found that ourselves in the last couple of years of web AR, for example, getting rid of the app. And when that then collides with 5G, which is and compatible devices, then that becomes, I think, really ubiquitous.
Absolutely, absolutely. Definitely looking forward to that world.
Yes. Well, Jeremy, this takes us up to our 10 minutes, and it's just whistled past. So thank you very much for joining us and sharing your thoughts. And the kind of takeouts that I've taken from this chat is, I think your approach of crawl, walk, then run. Don't think we have to change the world in one go. Then there's definitely a whole layer of data to prove the impact of the technology and then therefore justify the investment. And yes, that's I suppose the crescendo of volumetric with WebXR and then 5G that's going to power it all is really exciting.
It's a good summary, absolutely. And such an amazing world with so many facets that have yet to be explored. But I think we'll get there as an industry over the next few years for sure.
Jeremy, thank you very much. It's been an honour to have you on here, and we could chat for hours. But thank you for your time and sharing your thoughts with the XR world.
The pleasure is all mine. Thanks a lot, Martin.
Thank you. Bye-bye.